Welcome back, creative minds. If you're eager to dive into the world of captivating pattern design using Procreate, you've come to the right place. In today's tutorial, I'm going to unravel the magic of symmetry and repetition as we craft this simple repeating pattern design. Whether you're a seasoned Procreate user looking to expand your artistic horizons, or a passionate newcomer seeking to harness the power of digital design, this tutorial is tailored just for you. I'll be walking you through every step from setting up your canvas with our trusty diamond guide to weaving together symmetrical elements that leave you in awe of your own creativity. By the end of this video, you'll have the skills to effortlessly create stunning patterns that repeat seamlessly, transforming your artistic visions into designs that captivate the eye and spark imagination. If you're ready to elevate your Procreate prowess and explore the captivating world of pattern design, let's dive right in and uncover the secrets of symmetry and pattern. Okay, the first thing you want to do is create a canvas, and I am going to create a 3000 by 3000 pixel canvas. And I'm going to start by dragging in a background color. So I have a palette already selected. It only has three colors, a red, a pink, and a off-white. And then I'm just going to drag in the red color to create the background. And then we want to create a guide, so we're going to create a pattern that sits within a diamond. So I'm going to create another one and just drag a dark color in there, maybe a gray. And then I'm going to hit the selection tool, and then we want to make sure that snapping is on with magnetics and snapping on, and the distance and velocity all the way up. And grab a little green dot here and just rotate it to 45 degrees, and then all you need to do is grab the little edge here where the blue dot is, and it'll snap to the side of the canvas, and then do the same at the bottom, and then the top, and then the other side, until you have that diamond fitting very nicely inside the square. And then we can release that by hitting the arrow tool again. And then this is just a guide, so we're going to change that to multiply and then lower the opacity just enough so that we can see the guide, as we're going to draw our illustration inside this diamond. So we also want to lock that. So if you swipe to the right and select lock, that will prevent us from moving or changing that layer. The next thing we want to do is turn on symmetry. To do that, go up to the wrench tool, go to canvas, go to then this drawing guide option and toggle it on, and then click on edit drawing guide. And then we want to turn this one to symmetry. And then click on the options here and change it to quadrant. And what that means is that whatever you draw in one quadrant will repeat in the other ones. So click done on that. And then if we go into our layer, it's turned the drawing assist on that locked layer. We don't want that. We just want a new layer. And then we want to turn the drawing assist on that layer where we're going to draw. So I'm going to select drawing assist. And now anything I draw in here will repeat on the other four quadrants. So I'm going to just click with two fingers to undo that, and we're going to start the illustration. And to do this, we want to create it within that triangle guide there, and that will obviously repeat on the other quadrants as well. So I'm going to start with a flower, and I'm going to take that out from the middle and just go out to there. And if you're interested in the brush I'm using, it's just the standard 6B pencil, which comes with Procreate. And I'm just going to keep that for the entire illustration. And of course, you can draw whatever you like. I'm just going to draw some florals for mine. But you could draw whatever you like. You could draw some fruit, animals, whatever you desire. And you can see I'm coloring this in manually. There are other ways to do that. You could drag in a color into your line art, and then it will snap in place. You can change your threshold. If you go too high, it will take over the whole canvas. If you go too low, you can have lots of little gaps. But I like to just color it in myself. That way I get all the lovely texture of that brush over the entire surface where I am painting. And I think I'm going to draw some petals behind this. So I'm going to create another layer and put it behind that original layer. Turn on drawing assist again. And I'm going to select the pink color and draw some petals behind. You could also sketch this out first if you're not confident with just drawing straight off the bat, which is what I do most of the time. But for this, I'm just drawing straight on there so as not to keep this too long. And then you notice I forgot to turn on drawing assist, so I'm just going to undo that, go back in, turn on drawing assist, and continue drawing. And I think these need a bit of detail, so I'm going to add another layer, turn on drawing assist, and draw in some little dashes to give it a little bit more interest. Something that features in my work a lot. I actually find it quite meditative, drawing little dashes, little marks. Okay, I think that's done for the flower. I'm going to group all of those by swiping each layer to the right, then clicking on group. And then I'm going to create another layer, turn on drawing assist, and I'm going to draw some little flowers. And I'm going to group those little flowers and create another layer, and this time draw some leaves and branches. Okay, I'm pretty happy with that. I just want to do something in the middle. So I'm going to create another layer. And then for this one, I'm going to turn off drawing assist, or I haven't got it on anyway. So I want to draw a nice circle in the middle. And so I'm just going to draw the circle, and then I'm going to hold down my finger to create a perfect circle and then color that in. And then if I select it, I can snap it to the middle. If I've got the snapping on, you'll see the two orange lines vertically and horizontally, and that indicates that it is in the middle. And then below that, I want another layer with the drawing assist on. This time I'm going to change that slightly. I'm going to go back into the symmetry and go to options, and I'm going to turn on radial and rotational symmetry. We probably don't need that one, but I'm going to turn it on anyway. And then I'm going to draw some little petals, and they are just going to repeat once. Then color those in, and that creates a beautifully symmetrical pattern. And then I might just join that up so that looks like that little flower is coming out from behind. Like that. And then another layer on top of that. And I'm going to turn on the clipping mask. And so what that will do is that when I draw on this layer, it will stay within those petals. So I want to draw some little marks with my red. And I'm going to keep that same symmetry option on and create... Oops, drawing assist needs to be on, and then create some little lines like this. And then I want one more layer on top of that, and I'm going to select the pink. This time I'm turning the drawing assist back on again, And I'm just going to draw some little dots like that. Okay, that's looking pretty good. Now the next step is to turn this into a repeating pattern. So I'm going to turn off my drawing guide for the moment. We don't need that. And then I want to group everything. So I'm just going to group that last flower. And then I want to select all the groups and layers and create one big layer that holds the entire tile. And then I'm going to isolate that one by holding down the checkbox there. And so everything else has been turned off except that group. And I also want to turn off the background. So we've just got that pattern there. And then I'm going to use three fingers to swipe down, select copy all, and then three fingers to swipe down, and then hit paste. And what that's done is it's pasted a merged copy of that group. So I can go and turn on my background layer again now. And I'm going to duplicate this merged layer. And so we've got five copies. And then I'm going to turn off that original layer. And then for these, we want to put each of them, except the middle one, in the four corners. And so I'm going to grab that first one. If I hit the selection tool, if I were to move that now, you can see that it doesn't select the whole canvas. And so when we put it up there, it's not going to fit nice and snug and the repeat won't work. So to get away with that, let's remove all of these and we'll start again. We're going to put a little mark in the top left-hand corner and then the bottom right-hand corner. And now when I select that, it selects the whole canvas. So we want to duplicate that one, so we've got five copies. And then select one of them, make sure the snapping is all turned on, and then we're going to move it to the top. Make sure you get the orange line, and then over to the left. And then repeat that with this one to the top right. And then to the bottom left with the next layer. Really important to make sure you get the two orange lines. So you can see them down here in the edge here. And then across. And then the last one. Okay, and now you have a repeating tile. There's only one more thing we need to do before we test it, and that is remove the little marks that we created in the corners. And you can see them just in here, these little triangles. So I'm just going to select this one here, which is the bottom right-hand corner, and just delete that. And then we want the top left-hand corner, and we'll delete that. And now we can merge all of those layers together. So I'm just going to pinch them together and then duplicate that so I have five layers. And I'm going to turn off the bottom one. And then with these, I'm going to reduce the size to the quadrants. So that's the first one. Then the next one can go to the top right. Just always check that you've got the width. If you've got a 3000 by 3000, it's going to be half that size. So this one says 1500 by 1500. And then you know that it's the correct size. Sometimes it can be a little bit tricky and it gets a bit fiddly. But with practice, you'll get better at doing this. And there you can see that has repeated really nicely. And there you have a final pattern. I hope you found this tutorial on crafting repeating patterns using Procreate Symmetry tool both insightful and inspiring. Remember, the world of pattern design is as vast as your imagination, and with the tools and knowledge you've acquired today, there's no limit to the captivating designs you can create. If you enjoyed this tutorial and want to continue honing your digital artistry, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell to stay updated on more tutorials as I release them. Also, feel free to share your incredible creations in the comments below. I can't wait to see what you come up with. And for more pattern-specific tutorials, I recommend clicking on this playlist. Until next time, happy pattern making. See ya.